Hello everyone, I hope you guys are all having a fabulous day. Today I want to do a good old-fashioned what's in my bag, and the bag that I'm currently rocking is the Louis Vuitton Speedy 30 in the Demi Azure. Alright, so it's been quite some time since I've done one of these videos, and I don't know about you, but I love to see what people are carrying inside of their bags. Call me nosy, call me what you will, still some of my favorite videos to watch. And I am also challenging myself not to edit this video. Now, I know some of you couldn't care less. To me, it's a big deal, you know, and I just decided to go for it. And I am nervous. I am nervous for two different reasons. The first one being that I have a tendency to ramble. So hopefully this video isn't a million years long. And the other reason I'm nervous is because I am heavily medicated at the moment. Because as you can tell from the sound of my voice, I am sick once again. I know. Some of you guys are probably thinking, Minnie, why do you keep getting sick so often? I have no idea. I'm taking all the necessary precautions. I'm taking my vitamins and still it ended up getting me. So hopefully I don't end up hacking up a lung on camera because nobody wants to see that. You know what I mean? All right. So without further ado, let's get started. My goodness, longest intro ever. I don't really like long intros. You know what I'm saying? But let me show you guys what I got going on in here. It is a bit of a mess. I got home late last night, so I wasn't able to clean it out. And I will prop it up so you guys can see me take everything out. The only thing that I'm missing that's not in my bag is my phone. Because I'm hanging out at home, there's no reason why my phone needs to be in my bag, you know? All right, so first up, I have my Chanel O pouch. For those of you that follow me on Instagram, you guys have already seen it. But I didn't do like a formal unboxing or reveal or anything like that. I picked up this small leather good probably 2 weeks ago, 2.5 weeks ago, something like that. It is part of their current collection, and this is in the matte caviar leather with the chevron detailing with the champagne gold hardware, and the color is Dusty Rose? I can't remember. If I can find the name, I will put it on the description box below. I think it just says pink, to be honest. I think it just says pink, but I absolutely love it, and to me, this kind of screams spring, right? Especially when you pair it with a Demi Azure, I think it makes a really nice combination. It reminds me of the Louis Vuitton Rose Ballerine, but it has a little bit more of like a peach hue to it. But anyways, in here I have my key fob, I have some receipts and my driver's license. I was actually using this as a wallet the previous day, so I threw it in here. So I have half of my wallet in here and the other half is in there. And I like these O pouches to use them as wallets. Not that you can't use them as anything else. They're really great as catch-alls, but it can get really bulky really quickly if you end up putting too many items. But the reason why I like them as wallets is because in here you can end up putting pretty much your entire contents of your wallet, plus receipts and cash, and it doesn't take up too much space. It's very slender, so I don't know. I really like using them as wallets. So there's that guy. All right, next I have my Honey Lemon cough drops. My generic cough drops. It says compare to Halls. I think I got these at Walgreens. I don't know. I don't really like Halls. They don't really work for me. These guys do. I swear by them. But after like the third or fourth one, I really need one right now. After like the third or fourth one, they don't leave the best taste in your mouth. And I feel like you have either dragon breath or some funky, you know, some funkiness going on, and nobody wants that either. So they're good and they're not. Does that make any sense? Probably not. All right, next up I have my Chanel 6-ring key holder in the black caviar leather with the gold hardware. I've had this guy for 3.5, maybe 4 years. And I get a lot of questions if I still like my Louis Vuitton one. Do I still recommend that one over this one? I do. And the only reason why I've been using this within the last 3 years, you know, nonstop, I do switch into the other one from time to time. But that's because the Louis Vuitton one I used for like 9 years or 8 years straight. So this kind of gives it a little bit of, you know, it gives that guy some time out, you know, and it's actually held up a lot better than I ever anticipated. Not saying that caviar leather isn't, not that it's not carefree, but I just figured maybe the seams would start to pop open or maybe it would have a lot of wear on the sides. Absolutely nothing. I have put this thing through the ringer. Out of all my small leather goods, there are some that I really end up beating up that I don't pay attention to. This is one of them. This is one of the ones that I'm like, never will I put it in a bubble. It is what it is type of thing. And it's only until recently that I started to notice that it had a little bit of wear on the edges, which is normal, you know, because keys are deadly. They're sharp. They have unforgiving corners or edges. And the fact that this one looks the way that it does after, what, 3.5 years or however long I've had it, I think that's pretty good, you know? And this one is bulkier than the Louis Vuitton one. Just thought I'd throw that out there. And I like the fact that this does have a little, like a little compartment here for your driver's license. But it is a little bit bulkier, like I said. But I think it's awesome. Some people have said that it's discontinued. I don't know, to be honest, because some people have said that and other people have gotten it, you know, recently within the last couple of months. So don't quote me on it. But if you do end up seeing it, and if you are a fan of 6-ring key holders, highly recommend the Chanel one. But still, my Louis Vuitton one, oh yeah, end all be all, best small leather good of all time. Still, I still feel that way. all right, next up, Advil cold and sinus. That's what I got going on because it helps so that I'm not a complete mess on here, you know? I'm not all done up. Well, no, that's not true. I don't know. I'm not all done up like I normally would, I guess. My hair is kind of blah. okay, I also have my headphones, my Kleenex, because I need those as well. I'm the type of person, when I'm sick, I have Kleenex in like all of my bags. I have it in all of my jackets, my sweaters, not like the used ones. I know that sounds disgusting, but I have them everywhere because I don't like that sensation. I don't think anybody does. I don't like the sound that it makes. I don't like being sick. I don't mind the Marge Simpson voice. I don't mind that at all. I just don't like everything else that comes with it, you know? So anyways, next I have my Louis Vuitton round coin purse and the monogram canvas. I absolutely love this guy. I haven't had any issues with it whatsoever. And, you know, when it comes to coins, I don't really like to carry them in my wallet. I know that it is convenient, but the coin residue that it leaves is such a pain in the butt to remove. And I like to have something separate, something that is going to have that residue all on its own where I don't have to worry about it, you know? And this guy definitely ends up working out the best. Plus some of the other ones that I have in my collection, they're either maybe a little too bulky or they end up opening up on their own. And the fact that this has a zippered compartment really ends up working out the best for me. All right, next up are my Key Australia sunglasses. I don't want to blind you guys, they are mirrored. But these are the Desi Perkins collaboration, the high key, the originals. But just to show you guys, they are quite reflective. They are awesome. I absolutely love them. They're oversized. They're inexpensive, in my opinion. Although someone said that they went up in price. So I think when I got them, they were $65. But still, if you guys want a great pair of sunglasses that looks amazing, the high keys are kind of like an aviator style, I highly recommend them. And just Key Australia's in general. You know, I've said before in a million other videos, I've had the expensive sunglasses and I always feel like nervous or I break them, I lose them. And these guys, I have dropped them a million times and nothing happens to them. Nothing happens to them. So I'm a big, big fan of Key Australia. All right, next up, ibuprofen, generic ibuprofen. I think all ibuprofen is generic, isn't it? I don't know. But this stuff works wonders with my throat, so it doesn't feel like it's closing in on me. All right, I also have some more cough drops that are kind of rando. Next up, my cold hard cash. This guy I got at Z Gallery last year, and I think it was $20? No, I think it was $15. $15. It's kind of expensive for a little rando wallet, don't you think? But it's super cute. It's super cute. And I use it a lot during the spring and summer. I just really like the colors. But in here, it says cold hard cash. Am I carrying cold hard cash? No, I am not. In here, I'm carrying Blink contact eye drops. These are awesome. These are a huge thank you to you guys for recommending them. If you do wear contacts and if you do need new eye drops, I highly recommend these guys. Before I used to use Visine and a few others, and they always ended up drying out my contacts. You know how like when you get the slightest thing on your lens, it feels like you have rocks in your eyes? This like washes it all away and it feels amazing. So highly, highly recommend them. I got them at Target. And I also have some hair clips and bobby pins in here. You know, the funny thing is about these bobby pins and hair ties and what have you, I will load up my bag at the beginning of every month. And by the end of the month, I have maybe one or two things left. Like I said, with these guys as well, I don't know where they go. I don't know where they go. I don't know where I drop them. I never find them ever again, you know, and maybe they go to the land of hair products. I have no idea. But if you guys are like that as well, if that happens to you, let me know in the comment section down below. All right, next up, I have my Louis Vuitton mini pochette in the Tahitian Demi Azure. This collection was released 3 years ago, if I'm not mistaken. In here, I have, didn't I already have a key fob in here? I thought I did. Why do I have both of my fobs in here? I do. Lame. Okay, so my key fob. I also have my Chanel, Boy de Chanel lip balm. I got this for Christmas, and it's a super cute, you know, packaging. You guys know how I feel about packaging. It has the CC up there. It's matte. But the formula is almost identical, if not identical, to the OG lip balm, you know? So I don't really find a difference in it. I think it's really cute. Is it the most moisturizing? No. But I like the way that it looks. So there's the Boy de Chanel. They have a whole line that was recently released, I think within the last couple of months. All right, next up, I have my headache medicine in my pill container. I also have Oral-B Complete Satin Floss to keep those pearly whites going, and my Trident for that dragon breath, or when you have that funky taste of these guys, yeah, you need this. For sure. And last but not least, I have a purse hook. This was sent to me by a very, very good friend. And I absolutely love this. I like how compact it is. It fits in all of my small leather goods, no problem. And I love the fact that if I'm in a restaurant, if I'm somewhere where I can't give my bag an extra, you know, an extra chair or put it on the table, because yes, I am that type of person. I don't like to put it on the back of my chair. I like to have the bag somewhere where I can see it, you know? But the purse hook, if you don't have those other options, you just slap this guy on the table and you put your bag right there and you are good to go. So, I mean, I absolutely love this. She sent me two of them, but I use this guy the most. And that does it for my mini pochette. I really like this one. See what I mean? It's very similar to this one. I know this isn't Rose Ballerine, but it's very similar in color. I really like pairing these, or putting these three together. But that pink interior is gorgeous. All right. Next up, the other part of my wallet. This is the Chanel Small Zipped. I think they changed the name to Medium Zipped. This is in a teal caviar leather from a few seasons ago with a champagne gold hardware. And in here, like I said, I have the other parts in the other small leather good. I have a Nordstrom gift card. I have my Mega Millions ticket, which obviously I didn't win. Because, you know, I kept thinking, I'm like, oh man, I really want to win the lottery. You hear of all these like insane amounts, like what is it, like 500 million or some of them were a billion. And I'm like, oh, I want to win. How can I win if I don't play, right? So I'm trying to make a conscientious effort to play, but I forget a lot. I forget, I mean, all the time. But yeah, no winner. Winner, winner, no chicken dinner. All right, and then I also have receipts in here, my other credit card. What is this? My C's Candies. Yes, C's Candies gifts for the season gift card. It's $5 off. It's not a gift card. That's a lie. But See's Candies is awesome. If you guys are ever in California or if you get the chance to try out See's Candies, give them a shot. I know people feel very strong about certain, you know, chocolates. Like a lot of people like Godiva. My brother loves Godiva and there's a few others. I am like a hardcore like See's Candies fan. If it's not See's Candies, then I like Hershey's. I know. I like Hershey's. All right. Leave me alone. But try out See's Candies. It's awesome. I also have my daughter card. My mom gave me this, I think when I turned 18 in a birthday card. And I'm not going to read it to you because I'll start crying. But I carry this with me everywhere I go. And then what else do I have? Insurance. All the boring stuff. And my fishing license. Yes, you heard that correctly. My fishing license. My hubby enjoys fishing. My hubby enjoys the outdoors. And I like to support him in all the hobbies that he likes because he supports me in my hobbies. And I actually enjoy fishing. So I like going out with him, whether it's freshwater or ocean fishing. And sometimes I catch more fish than he does, but I do like fishing with him. But anyways, the Chanel zipped wallet, medium zip wallet, I think, or maybe it's now the small zip wallet. What is this? What is that? I have glitter. It's probably from my lip gloss. I have glitter all over here. Do you guys see that? Ah! I ruined it. No, I didn't. I could take that off. I feel like I have glitter on a lot of my small leather goods. All right. And last but not least, oh, I also have more cough drops and a solo gum. That guy shouldn't be by itself. I also have my Gucci Ophidia Cosmetics case. I think that's the name. This is in the small size, but I love this guy. I think it's awesome. Haven't had any issues whatsoever. In here, oh yeah, you know what I have in here. My lip products. First up, the Creme de Rose of Christian Dior. Someone said that these were discontinued. I will be so bummed out if these have been discontinued. One of the best lip balms, in my opinion. Way more moisturizing than the Chanel one. And it smells like roses. It's amazing. So hopefully, fingers crossed, that it's not discontinued. All right. I also have my Chanel Chance. This is my perfume. I got this a few months ago, and it was like a little set. It came with this guy and three of these little vials. And I really like this fragrance. It's really light. It's very springy. Excuse me. Oh my gosh. Sorry about that. I'm not going to edit the video. Trust me, it's taking everything in me not to turn it off and like get rid of this, but we got to keep it this way. Anyways, the Chanel Chance, the green one, I really like it. It smells awesome. And I really like this packaging because I'm not always one to carry like fragrances with me just in case they end up like leaking, but I like the fact that it does have, it does have a little container for itself. On its own. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. All right. Next up, I have my Bucks. My light is flashing because I think I'm running out of battery. So give me a second. Fresh new battery, good to go. So like I said, this is the Power Plump Lip Balm in Big O. It looks like it's colorless, but if you put on quite a bit, like I'm about to, it turns kind of bright pink. Not bright pink, but it's a little bit brighter. I like the formula. It's minty. It's amazing. Yeah, it's good. It's good stuff. I'm a buxom girl. You guys know that. All right. Next up, speaking of buxom, my favorite all-time favorite lip gloss, the Celeste lip gloss from Buxom. This color is amazing. It has just the right amount of sparkles, and the formula is awesome. And I've tried a lot of lip products. I've tried a lot of lip glosses. The only one I haven't really tried out is the Sarah Lip Slip? Is that what it's called? Maybe I'm saying something different. Hopefully I'm not. I haven't tried that one, but if I come across it, I will definitely pick it up. But in my opinion, out of everything that I've tried out, this is by far the best. All right. And I also have a little baby, Celeste. You can never have enough. You can never have enough, right? All right, and I also have my Charlotte Tilbury Very Victoria lipstick. This is really similar to their Pillow Talk. It's a little bit darker, I think, but it really works out with my skin tone. There it is. It's a beautiful color. I just like their lipsticks. I mean, I think it's one of the best formulas out there. I think for me, it's kind of like a tie between Christian Dior lipsticks and Charlotte Tilbury, right? What do you guys think? All right, but anyways, I also have my Chanel hand cream. This hand cream doesn't smell like Chanel No. 5 or anything like that. It has a very, it has like a rosy, like a floral scent to it, but a very light one. It's not too overwhelming. It smells amazing. It's very moisturizing. It is a bit of a splurge. But I really like it. I actually have two different ones. And out of the two, I think I prefer the original one just because it, It smells a little bit softer, you know? It kind of smells like Chanel Cosmetics. That's what it smells like. All right, and last but not least is my Bond number 9 lipstick. The hubby got this for me for Valentine's Day. This is in the color Chelsea, if I'm not mistaken. I like Bond number 9 fragrances, and when I saw that they came out with lipsticks, I was all about it. So the fact that he surprised me for Valentine's Day, I was like, I was super, super excited. But I really like the packaging. It's very, very beautiful, but there is the color. The formula is moisturizing. It doesn't dry out your lips. It doesn't feather or anything like that. So I really like that. It doesn't smell, does it? Do you guys hear Edward snoring? It doesn't smell either. So I just really like it. And the gift pack that he got me came with a refillable one to put in there. So that was really nice. But anyways, that does it for my Gucci Ophidia Cosmetics case. And that does it for my Speedy 30. I love this bag. And kind of like what I said earlier, this is my favorite when it comes to handheld Speedies. And I prefer the Speedy 25 Bandolier for crossbody because it's not too big and it doesn't protrude off my body as much as the 30 does. But the 30, I really like the fact that you have a generous opening when it comes to the Classic. You can fit all of your items inside. It can get heavy at times, but I love this silhouette and I love the Speedy sag that it has at the bottom. But it's definitely one of my favorites, and I'm sure you guys can tell that the color has changed as well. Because when I first had this, it was a little bit of a brighter white, and now it's a little bit more of a yellowish tint. And that just goes with age. As it ages, it'll start to kind of change a little bit. It'll start to turn a little bit yellowish. And you know, a lot of the, like the monogram pieces on the monogram itself, some of them are a little bit more caramel, others are a little bit more, have a little bit more of a green tint. These will also end up, if you have a big variety, if you have a big collection of Demi Azur pieces, they won't all look the same. They won't all be that bright, bright white, because they do end up differing just a tad from each of the rolls of the canvas that they use. But like I said, this guy was a little bit brighter once upon a time, but I've had it for 6 years, going on 6 years. And yeah, it's starting to have that little bit of the yellowish tint. I don't mind it at all, because to me, I like the pairing with the patina that the Vaquetta has. I think it looks really nice together. So that's just something I want to throw out there just in case, because check these two out. You can really see the difference on the Demi Azur. This one is still maybe a little bit brighter, whereas this one has a lot more of that yellow tint to it. Anywho, see what I mean? Totally, totally rambling. But anyways, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure and give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already and you would like to, please subscribe to my YouTube channel by clicking on the red button down below and hitting that bell so you're notified when I upload videos, which is anywhere from 2 to 3 times a week. And I'm curious, besides your car keys, besides your wallet, besides your driver's license, your credit cards, what's the one thing that you absolutely have to carry with you in all of your bags, whatever it is? To me, you know what it is. You know what it is. It's gotta be lip gloss. I really don't care about anything else. I mean, I have to carry those, you know, those 3 items that I said, but like I have to have lip gloss. So that's my thing. But I would love to know if you want to share in the comment section down below. But again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you later. And as always, make it a fabulous day or not. The choice is yours. Have a great day.